A measure meant to stop bullying in schools is gaining ground in Congress. The House Committee on Basic Education and Culture has unanimously approved the bill requiring elementary and secondary schools in the country to adopt policies against bullying. Here's a look.
The Committee on Basic Education and Culture of the House of Representatives has approved a measure designed to discourage bullying in schools. The bill has been submitted to the plenary for deliberations. House Bill 5248, or the Anti-Bullying Act of 2010, defines bullying as any act that could be hurtful to the victim, whether unwanted physical contact or an act that constitutes harassment or provocation. The bill also provides measures aimed at reforming bullies. It also empowers and compels schools to address bullying through measures that protect students from irreparable physical, psychological, emotional, and mental harm. Schools who fail to impose such measures risk administrative sanctions from the Education Secretary. Aurora Representative Juan Edgardo Angara, one of the authors of the bill, says the problem of bullying has reached alarming proportions in schools. A study commissioned by the United Nations Children's Fund, or UNICEF, the Council for the Welfare of Children, and Plan International shows most students in the grade school and high school levels have experienced various forms of abuse, mainly verbal abuse, either from their peers or from their teachers. The study also showed the child's peers, more than the adults, were the ones who commit the acts of violence.
And joining us on Hot Copy, Aurora Representative Juan Edgardo Angara, co-author of the Bill Against Bullying. Good day to you, Sunny.
Hi. Morning, Karen.
Okay, now define what is bullying based on the House Bill.
Well, bullying under the House Bill, it's acts done by one student against another student.
Okay.
So those are the actors. It must be severe and repeated.
Okay.
And the effect is to damage the person, to place the other student in fear of harm to his person or to his property.
Okay.
And to affect the atmosphere of the school.
Now, what are the specific acts that constitute bullying?
Well, we enumerated a few in the
yeah.
bill. No, there's the usual, the pushing, the pinching, and
okay.
the punching.
Pinching.
Punching and. Also, there's also cyberbullying. Cyberbullying.
No, but what about teasing?
Teasing, it's not explicitly stated. I don't think. But if it's repeated and it's severe, I think
okay.
it can be considered.
All right.
A form
no, because you struck out certain descriptions that constitute bullying, like eyes rolling if a person takes you out of a group.
Yeah, yeah. I think. It's hard to avoid. It's really tough where to draw the line, no, Karen. Because
yeah.
kids will be kids. You know?
Yeah.
And we all went through that stage where.
Yes.
We took out that description and not being part of the group. Kasi ano naman yun eh, you're free to choose who
yes.
you want to associate.
Yeah,
with.
And it's part of growing up that sometimes you experience these things.
Yeah.
But bullying to you is really what?
It's really there's an element of intimidation.
Okay.
It really places a person in fear.
Okay.
Like it affects his studies in such a way that psychologically he's not himself.
Now, why did you think that it was time for us to put something like this into law? Why?
Well, actually, it's very personal to me because my there was an incident of bullying involving my son when he was in nursery.
Okay.
In his school. He was early and he was playing with some friends. And I think three of them, what the report came to me is that three ganged up on him and they pushed him to the ground and he fell on his
head.
On his head. And he was brought to the ICU. Cardinal Santos.
Uh-oh.
And you know, of course, I was very upset. I got a call in the middle of the day from my wife, and our son's in the hospital. And I called it. Of course, I was very upset. I called up the school.
The school.
And one of the first things they told me was that you shouldn't send your son to school so early because we avoid the traffic. You know, so parang kami pa yung kasalanan.
Oh.
So we're a little bit upset. So we wrote the school and said, you know, it's not our. You should have policies in place. You should make sure there's teachers who are supervising the students
yes.
even while they're not in the classroom.
Yeah. But were the three kids bullies? When you say bully, you said it has to be repeated.
Yeah. In this case, I think it was more of an accident, really, to be honest.
Uh-huh.
But I think the point is still drive it home that schools should be responsible for what
yes.
happens because it could be much worse and there could be actual incidents of bullying. But in this case, I think you're right. It wasn't so much bullying per se. But
it could be yeah. because there are three.
Well, if it happened again,
yeah.
I guess you could
consider. No, but there are three of them. They ganged up on your son.
Yeah.
In a way, that I would say that that would fall under bullying. Huh?
Well, but I don't think they had the intent really to harm him. I think they were just, in this case, in my particular case, I think it was just them being rough,
okay,
and being very
But were you ever bullied as a student?
Yeah, I was also. But nothing severe like that. Not physical, but more of, you know, you get the dirty looks. So you see someone look at you, you kind of walk in a different direction.
Yeah.
But very minor, hindi grabe.
All right. But then again, the UNICEF also is alarmed with bullying. The UNICEF study and the Council of the Welfare, all right, saying that students in grade school and high school are already experiencing various forms of abuse. So bullying is abuse.
Yes, for them. But I think they included in their study also bullying by teachers. This bill only talks about bullying by students.
Why didn't you just include the teachers so it's all in
because
one?
Because I think student bullying by a fellow student is it's a special kind of bullying. Because that's something that we must be concerned with. Because kids cannot really take care of themselves, diba?
Yeah.
We the adults in the society have to be the ones to provide a safe framework for them. I think teachers, they can be dealt with. You can file cases against them.
I see.
We have laws to deal with that.
Yeah, I had a teacher that was a bully.
You have the revised penal code. You have, there's a law against violence for women and children.
Okay.
So there's specific laws to deal with that.
All right. And how bad is bullying in the Philippines?
Well, according to that study, I think 4 out of 10 for grades 1 to 3. 4 out of 10. And then
are bullied?
Yeah, and then it gets
worse.
That's
a lot.
From grade 4 to 4th year high school, I think it's 6 or 7 out of 10 in between, 65%.
Are you serious?
Yeah, so...
Oh, and what is... Tell me, when you were doing this house bill, what exactly is the profile of a bully? Why do they bully and what makes them bullies?
Yeah, that's an interesting question, Karen. According to some of the psychiatrists who we talked to, they said a lot of times there's an underlying cause. The bullying is just the symptom or the result of something underlying. And parang minsan sa bahay daw walang boses yung bata. Kasi his parents are very strict.
Okay.
Or minsan it's even a case where there's violence in the house.
Okay.
And he's just reflecting it
in school.
Okay. So things like that.
Or could it be that the child, the bully, is also not disciplined at home? Is that possible or
that's
not?
That's possible.
Really?
I think that's also possible. Yeah.
So do most schools in the Philippines, they don't have policies?
It seems to me that that a lot of schools don't. There's a lot of variance with how they deal with it.
Okay.
And it seems to me in the case of my son's school, there wasn't really a policy. And I think the tendency was, parang normal lang yan eh. Parang ganon. I think that's the common attitude.
Yeah.
So I guess part of me filing this bill is, you want to raise awareness about the problem also.
Yeah. Now,
you don't want it to reach the proportions that it has in the States, for example. Napakaraming serious incidents there. You have people shooting.
Yeah, or suicide.
Suicide.
Yeah. Mm. No, but under the bill, who do you penalize?
Well, it's not really a penal statute, Karen. It's just you're telling schools, hey, you know, this is a problem in society and you must have policies for it.
Okay.
And these policies must involve the schools, it must involve the parents, and it must involve the students. And the emphasis is not really penal. Ayaw mo sabihin, hindi naman yung punto nung batas is paparusahan mo lang yung bata. Kasi under our penal philosophy, hindi naman sila responsible, di ba? We have the Juvenile Justice Act. Sa akin, it's a holistic framework. You want to raise awareness, but you also want to correct the problem.
Correct. Oh, and you want adults involved.
Very
you want
much.
Adults involved.
Definitely.
Now, cyberbullying has been a growing problem in many schools, especially that have computers, Facebook, everything in the school. You included that?
That's included, yeah.
Okay.
It can be done through texting, through Facebook, through Twitter. But the problem, I guess, it's a different kind of bullying in terms of proving it. It's more difficult because a lot of cyberbullying is anonymous.
Yeah.
So that's the problem. It's just an evidentiary problem there.
Okay.
How to prove it. But it happens. You're right.
So what happens if a child is a bully repeatedly? Does the bill encourage that they should suspend the child or dismiss
Actually,
the
we
child?
We leave it to the school to
I see.
To we define what bullying is and that they must penalize it. They must prohibit it in their schools.
Okay.
But it's up to them how they want to. Like if they want sabihin nila na First violation, warning, second violation, one month counseling. It's up to them. We didn't want to dictate on schools in that sense.
All right, lots of questions from Twitter. We can start. Next night, baby, a lot of the bullying happens when the teachers are not around, so it's hard to prove. Do you agree?
That's true. That's why it's important. There are provisions in the law which state that we encourage kids who've seen it to come out, and we protect them also.
I see.
Because a lot of times, that's correct what the questioner said. A lot of it happens in places like in the football field, on the staircases where there are no teachers.
Yes.
Or in the bathrooms.
Yes.
So.
No, that's a good point that you want to encourage people to care, students, and come out.
You can even have anonymous complaints, but the safeguard to that is that you could penalize people if it's a false accusation.
Kasi sa school, aalaskin ka kapag sumbungera ka eh. Sumbungero, pakilamero.
That's true.
You ranted on me, pero you're encouraging that.
We're encouraging that, and we're also saying that teachers should not penalize a kid for telling on another.
Of course.
We want the adults to be responsible in this case, because kids will really do it, you know.
Okay. This is interesting. Viking Lugarta, please remind your guests to attend the important UP Board of Regents meeting at 9. Are you attending that?
I'm going there after.
All right, he's going there. All right, this is hilarious that they advise through Twitter. Badman Mahama, there are too many avenues for bullying today. Is cyberbullying, how can this be incorporated in the bill?
It's already there. It's bullying through electronic means, through texting. It's the same. It's the same elements. It's done by a student. It's severe. It's repeated, and the effect is deleterious to the victim.
All right, Gang Badoy is asking: were you ever bullied? Did you ever bully, or did you ever witness a child being bullied? Did you tell?
That's a lot of questions. Yeah. Was I a bully? No.
No, you don't look like a bully.
Alaskador lang, alaskador. Was I a victim of bullying? Not physical bullying, but more of.
Mental,
intimidating,
bossy.
I guess it's normal.
But did you ever witness a kid being bullied?
I'm trying to remember. Yeah, quite a number
did
of times.
Did you ever tell?
No, not really. Not really.
Not
I think
time.
It's not the natural self-protection also. Yeah. So, I remember when I was a student in England when I first left after high school.
Were you bullied?
No, but
in
I
England?
Was subject to racial. They would call me like Nippon and Paki. All Asians to them are either a Nippon or a Paki.
Because
Indians or Chinese are
Yes, that's bullying.
I think if it's repeated,
that's
it's a form
bullying,
of bullying.
Yeah.
So I was subjected to a little bit of that when I was young. But I overcame it by play. They look up. It's very much like a US where you have this jock culture. They see that you're okay at sports. You're okay. You're either smart or you're good at sports.
So what were you good at?
I played basketball, and no one played basketball there. And
I
played
really?
Tennis also.
See.
And so I made the school teams, and you know, kind of the bullying faded away.
Yeah, but bullying, would you consider that like kunyari pandak, maitim? Is that part of bullying?
If it's severe and repeated, if the effect is like if it's five people doing it, I think and they're part of a group. Medyo.
Because there are things that are politically incorrect. You can't even like for example, if there's a person that's obese, adults aren't even allowed to say, di ba parang nubha, taba taba. You know, you can't even do that. It's not politically correct anymore because you know obesity is a disease.
That's right.
In school, in a way, that's part of it, no?
Yeah, I guess if it's an isolated incident, okay lang yon, di ba? If spontaneously or if it's in self-defense, nag-aaliskahan, that's okay.
Okay. All right, we'll take a quick break. When we return, our guest, Congressman Sunny Angara, will answer more questions from you, our viewers. Hot Copy will be right back.